Police trying to stamp out a crime blamed on thieves known as the Felony Lane Gang. They specialize in stealing purses left in cars.
Unfortunately, it's become a pretty popular mode of criminal activity, and it's something that we've cracked down on here in Jacksonville.
That crackdown has now landed more suspected thieves in jail.
The crime trend, which we've been warning you about for months, seems to keep growing. And now three more people are charged with stealing victims' bank information, then trying to clean them out by posing as those victims. Locally, we've seen it in Duval, St. John's, and Clay counties. These latest arrests involve cases in Duval and Clay. 24-year-old Naomi Hill, 28-year-old Nathan Sullivan, and 28-year-old Trenard Shingles were all recently arrested. Channel 4's Vic Micolucci talked with police and with one woman who says she was one of their victims. Vic?
Mary, detectives say the crooks will steal your credit cards, your debit cards, and your checks, and they'll take them to a local bank, and they will use that last lane at the bank teller to drive up there, sometimes in disguise, because they want the bank employees to think that they are you, and that is where they got the name, the Felony Lane Gang. They go to that furthest one away so that people can't catch on to their scheme, and they try to withdraw as much money as they can as quickly as possible.
A huge headache.
Sunny Rigdon, who asked us not to show her face, says she was at her cousin's baby shower when the crooks struck, breaking into her car and several others and stealing purses.
My ID, my credit cards, my military ID, I had tax documents.
Then they took all that information and tried to use it to take all Rigdon had.
It was about a week later when they tried to cash a check to me, and then they were writing checks from me also.
Rigdon, already aware of the theft, shut down her account and took it to Jacksonville police, who arrested these two, Naomi Hill and Nathan Sullivan. The scheme police say they used is sweeping the country and is prevalent throughout Northeast Florida. It's a problem deputies in St. John's and Clay counties say they're dealing with as well, more and more. Recently, Clay authorities tracked down Trenard Shingles in South Florida. He was wanted for a string of crimes up here.
They tend to target daycares, gyms, churches.
Jacksonville police officer Shannon Hartley has helped solve some of the Felony Lane cases over the years. He says the criminals are targeting people who feel safe. They often work in small groups and they move quickly.
A lot of times, for example, they're from out of town. So they'll drive up from another area of Florida, for example. They'll conduct these criminal activities in Jacksonville. And then they'll take their stuff and go home.
It's illegal activity that has police and banks on high alert. Rigdon says she hopes to see the people accused of trying to rip her off spend a long time behind bars.
I would love to see them go to prison.
And two of the suspects, Trenard Shingles and Naomi Hill, are still in jail tonight. Nathan Sullivan has since bonded out of jail. I did try to call his cell phone, but nobody answered, so therefore I could not get his side of the story. Live in San Marco, I'm Vic Micolucci, Channel 4, the local station.
Vic, we keep hearing the term Felony Lane Gang. Do police think everyone involved in these schemes knows each other?
No, police say it's a very organized scheme that people are picking up on, but Mary, they do not believe that these people are connected. They say it appears usually they work in small groups, maybe 3 to 5 people, and they commit these crimes, but they're not necessarily all a gang. It's just a term that they picked up because they're using the same MO and they're doing the same thing to carry out their criminal acts.
I see. Okay, Vic Micolucci reporting to us live.